العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى we will continue from the lessons of the Sunan of Imam Tirmidhi while waiting any for the others in attending the classes. And we begin by praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah bless in this dissertation by the barakah of the sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We pray that Allah protect us from all difficulties, trials and tribulations in dunya and akhirah. May Allah bless us husnul khatimah and get us with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yawm al-qiyamah. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. In our last any lesson, we were speaking any about the etiquettes of entering the toilet. Al-Imam Tirmidhi mentioned a few narrations in this regard, and most of us, we have memorized at least one dua of entering any the toilet. And the dua that usually we memorize is Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. This is any one of the narrations in Sunan of Al-Imam Tirmidhi. So this is what we have mentioned in our last lesson. So from where we have stopped, we have come to the hadith number 6, where the author mentioned, "Qala shaykhu Malik wa rahimahullah naf'ahu bihi wa bikum bi darain amin wa qala radiyallahu an akhbarana Ahmad ibn Abdah ad-Dabbi al-Basri qala hadathana Hannad ibn Zayd an Abdul Aziz bin Suhayb an Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu an أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا دخل الخلاء قال اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. قال أبو عيسى هذا حديث حسن صحيح. This is the hadith on the dua which we mentioned earlier. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. And last week I explained basically the meaning. الخبث is the plural of خبيث. And this is any one of the names of the shaitan. Shaitan any of the male shaitan. Khaba'is is the plural of khabitha. And khabitha yani is a female shaitan. Wa Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us any to seek the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from any the devil, whether it is any the male devil and the female any devils. Then any he mentioned Babu ma yaqulu idha faraja min al-khala. Then any he mentioned the dua or the adab, the recitation, when a person exits into the toilet. And after he mentioned about the dua of entering the toilet, he speaks any about the dua that we recite when we leave any the toilet. As we read any in Bidayatul Hidayah, for example, Al-Imam Ghazali mentioned any that when we leave any the toilet, any we leave any with our right leg first. When we enter into the toilet, any we enter in with with our left leg. So basically, in Islam, any place that is dirty, it is sunnah for us to enter with our left leg. And when we enter into clean places, like the masjid in our houses, it is a sunnah that we enter with our right leg. So he mentioned, قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدُ بْنُ إِسْمَعِيلِ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا مَالِكُ بْنُ إِسْمَعِيلِ عَنْ إِسْرَائِيلِ بِنْ يُونُسِ عَنْ يُوسُفِ إِبْنْ أبي بردة عن أبيه عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا خرج من الخلاء قال غفرانك. قال أبو عيسى هذا حديث حسن غريب لا نعرفه إلا من حديث إسرائيل يوسف بن أبي بردة وأبو بردة بن أبي موسى اسمه عامر بن عبد الله بن قيس العشعري ولا نعرف في هذا الباب إلا حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this hadith is related by Aisha, where she mentioned that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he exited in the toilet, he said, "Ghufranaka, ghufranaka." This is one of the negations that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked Allah for forgiveness. And the meaning of "ghufranaka," meaning I seek the ghufran of Allah. Ghufran is forgiveness. It is a sunnah that we ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we exit any the toilet. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us this etiquette. But if a person and he asks any, what is the wisdom behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking forgiveness after exiting any the toilet, our ulama, when they speak any about this particular hadith, any they mention that when we enter into the toilet, we receive a lot any of the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one any of the biggest any ni'mah that Allah bless any insan is the ni'mah of afiyah. The ni'mah any of afiyah. When we enter into the toilet, when we any release, this is any one any of the reason any that we are able any to stay alive. We have removed any poison and harm any from our bodies. Because our bodies and it being deprived from urine and feces, what will happen that it can cause any severe harm, can lead any to death. So when we enter into the toilet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy any upon us any to release any of those harms, any from our bodies. And this is a ni'mah. This is any a big any ni'mah. So that is why in another narration the Prophet that he mentioned, Alhamdulillahilladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa'afani. Yani, the Prophet that he mentioned, all praise and be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has removed any from me all types any of harms, al-adha wa'afani, and he has blessed me any with afiyah, health. So going any into the toilet any is one any of the ways of preserving any of our health, and this is a ni'mah from Allah. Afiyah yani is one any of the greatest any ni'mah that Allah bless any insan. So that is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, anybody who asks any Allah for something, ask Allah afiyah. Ask any from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-afiyah, health. So when we exit any into the toilet, then we ask Allah any for forgiveness, because we are unable to repay Allah for the blessings and bounties that Allah bless us. And imagine any if Allah any were to create a human being that is not able any to urinate, not able any to remove any all these harms any from his bodies. Yani he will be any in a severe any state. He will be in a state of helplessness. And if we find any, for example, some people any Allah tested them any with certain any disease that they are unable any to urinate. So what happened was the doctor make any a hole any in the body. Then urine any comes out any from the stomach. And we can imagine how difficult any that can be. We pray that Allah bless us in afiyah. So this is one any of the greatest any ni'mah. And we are unable any to ask to repay any this ni'mah to Allah. And we ask any Allah any for forgiveness because of our shortcomings in repaying any this ni'mah. That we are receiving any ni'mah any from Allah. And many a times any we perform any ma'asiyah. We disobey any Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despite Allah constantly bless us anyway His blessings. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that when you leave any the toilet, ask Allah for forgiveness. So usually any what do we recite? We say Ghufranaka Alhamdulillahilladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa'afani. Al-Imam Ghazali in Bidayatul Hidayah mentioned another narration that has any slight a difference in this lafaz, but the meaning is about the same. Yani after we ask Allah for forgiveness, and we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for verily and He has blessed us with this blessing, then we are able to remove the harmony from our bodies. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless us and with this blessing and bounties, and may Allah enliven in our hearts and with iman and taqwa, and bless us any the ability to emulate our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in each and every action, and may Allah constantly any bless us with goodness in dunya, goodness in akhirah, and husnul khitam inshaAllah ta'ala. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Rabbana taqabbal mu'ana innaka samiul alim, tub alayna innaka tawwabur rahim, wa aqim bisalihati a'malana wa ajim wa Allah yakrim bi fadli subhanahu wa ta'ala bil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun ala al mursalin, walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.